everyone, this is Animal Love Bug 101 here with a piggy update. This is Molly, in case you do not know. So Molly, she is not very happy because I don't have any of her things in her cage for a very, very good reason. As you can see, this may not be the place you're used to looking at in my videos. And that is because I have a new bedroom, because we have a new house, because my family moved. And because of that, I had room for a CNC cage, which I just set up just now. So I'm really happy. It is a 3x2, because I just have one pig. I have enough to make a 3x4, I mean a 2x4, but I don't think I have enough room practically. I mean, I guess I could squeeze it in, but it wouldn't look as good, and I only have one pig currently, so yeah, this is a good size for her. So I'm just gonna briefly show you around before she messes it all up. I got the cubes at Kohl's. I'm gonna need to fix that one, never mind. I got the cubes at Kohl's. I got two packages of them so I can make a base. They were about, originally, their normal price is about $40 each per package of 16, but I got them on sale. They were already 50% off, so they're 20, and then I had 20% off, so I spent about $35-ish on the cubes alone. Haven't got chloroplast. You might be wondering what this is. Basically, if you can see, what you were seeing right there is I had a cardboard box because I had one lying around. I put some trash bags over it and a lot of saran wrap. Like, good old saran wrap can fix anything along with duct tape. And I'm using that temporarily until I can go out and buy some chloroplast, which hopefully I can do that soon. And I'll show you guys when that comes. But I'm gonna get some nice, pretty chloroplast in there. Hopefully this will work good temporarily. I'll help you get back on that. So people who, you know, think of making guinea pig cages. But always buy the cubes first before you buy the chloroplast, because you have to measure the inside. Under the fleece, I have a layer of paper, not paper towels, but a lot of, newspaper, and then I have a layer of some old towels, and then I have the fleece. So in case you guys were wondering, and I'm hoping the fleece system works better out in a bigger cage, because I'm planning on vacuuming it or spot cleaning every day. That is my plan. Inside, over in this corner, she has a little container that was oatmeal, because gotta love oatmeal. Right here she has a little bell. I love these little clips. These clips are amazing because I can hang stuff on them, and then at the same time they're reinforcing the grids, so it's really a win-win situation if you think about it. But she has her bell right there. Right here she has the guinea pig potty, which I'm now using as a hay rack. And I'll get back to you and see if that's a good idea. I saw on several CNC cages, so I'm hoping it works out. Right there is a little stuffed leopard that we had that was about to be thrown away. So I'm like, hey, might as well let my pig play with it before I throw it away. There is her little hut. And there is another stuffed animal that has the same situation as a leopard. And right there is a sock that's all rolled up for her to roll around. You can do this with old socks. You can do this with paper towels, my holders. My guinea pig loves chewing the paper towel rolls so much. And you can crumple up just copy paper and just have them have a blast with that. Right here, this is her favorite one. This is the little beanie baby that jingles. She loves it so much. The good thing about having these up is that I've had this one since I got her. And you can just keep on hanging them up, and they don't get dirty because they're not on the ground. Over here, I put down a little old rag for her, but this is her food section. I have her old food dish to catch water from the water bottle. And I have the sitter feeder in there because I'm hoping that will create less mess because she always tips this over. Which was fine when I had aspen bedding in there, but I really don't want to get this all dirty. So let's hope she keeps it clean. Underneath, in the middle section, I have her food. Currently, she is on this guinea pig diet from Hearts. And it has like a lot of good treats and stuff. She loves it to death. But I had it from a friend whose guinea pig passed away. So I'm just trying to use up what I have. And I'm mixing it with her other diet. Katie, hey, I have another stash of it all the way over there in that lovely little box. So, plenty of Katie hay, extra grids and connectors. And here I have some cable ties, which I kind of need to use in a second. This was just a lid for the oatmeal container. This is a brush that was for Build-A-Bear, which I used to brush her with because she likes it. Bag of treats. Thing for Easter for treats, human. Real steel brush because her other guinea pig cage, this one, her past owners really didn't take care of her, so it's, well, I don't know how well they took care of her, but they didn't clean her cage a lot, so the bottom is really nasty. So I would use this to try to get as much as I can each cleaning, and there's still a lot of junk out in there after having her for almost a year now. The anniversary of her is coming up soon. Clean cage deodorizer. Vitamins, which I do not use unless a vet tells me to. I was just given them, and so I just have them in here. And a cage carrier, which I got when we moved, so I can move her and also keep her when I clean the cage. So, and behind it is just the boxes that the grits came in. Here is another box. These are just crates you can buy at Walmart. Pretty cheap. I just had them, and they fit it, so it works well. These are for newspaper. This has a animal ads. LOL. Extra trash bags. I mean, Walmart box. Old tape holder, which I hated. It's just there. Fleece that is cut up small. Extra sock toys. Bottle brush I got at Dollar Tree. It works good enough. Scooper. Baking soda. Amazing. And doggy bags for picking up poop. So, and then I have this old outside carpet to help protect the carpet. So that is her cage. And I'm about to stop the video to put her in. And I'm really hoping she popcorns and gets all excited. So I'm about to record that in a second. So I put her in, her first thing she goes for her hut. Now she's walking around, exploring everything. It's a big cage, isn't it, baby girl? Oh, I'm so happy. I've been wanting this cage forever. Just exploring around. Don't go back there. Oh my goodness, talk about mess. Okay, so this is the second time I had to film her getting in the cage for new. Because I figured out why they always say you need to use cable cords with those. Because she tips them over. And she tips it over. Yeah, didn't fail. So I just, for the night now, have a whole bunch of rubber bands keeping it on. Hopefully that's going to work. So yeah, first thing she did on the first time, though, is went straight to her little home. Now she's going out to explore the world of her new cage. Oh, I'm so happy. This is really awesome. Don't you dare mess up this cage, girly. Yep. That's about it. This is Animal Lovebug 101.